Welcome back, everyone, to more NASCAR 21 Ignition. And today we're talking patch notes for the recently released version 1.2.5. And this version is what I will call the beginning of several things that need to be addressed in order for this game to be both fun and viable for the near future. If you're following along with my career mode series, then we talked about in the most recent video how at this point, the game is just not fun for me, and I'm waiting for the developers to get it to a point where I believe it's sustainable and fun over the long term. So 1.2.5 hopefully will be the beginning of that process. It's not the first patch they've released, but at this point, hopefully we can move forward and get this game where it needs to be at an absolute minimum in order for future enjoyment. So version 1.2.5 available for Xbox, PlayStation, as well as for the PC through the Steam platform. Now, I personally play through the PC on the Steam platform, so that is what I will tend to focus the most on as we continue moving down through these patch notes. Now, the patch was released a couple of days ago as of the recording of this video back on the 18th. And while we're talking about dates and updates, keep in mind that if you ever want to know what's going on with the channel, or if maybe there's been a few days or more without any videos uploaded, hop over to our NePit Gaming Discord, and that's where I can post a lot more personal information about schedules and my plans, and maybe some real life things that have crept up, and maybe why I'm not posting any videos. So again, hop over to the Discord. I'll put a link in the description down below so you can keep up to date on exactly what's going on here at NePit Gaming. We start off the patch notes with something that is highly requested: the hardware and peripherals. This is where you can see a long list of very popular wheels in sim racing that they needed to add support for. Now, where there were some workarounds that people were using to get wheel support where there wasn't native wheel support, but now hopefully we have a lot more support and more to come in the future. We see a lot of Thrustmaster here, some Fanatic as well, but hopefully again we're going to get more and more improvements as time goes along. These are things that certainly should have been there from the release, but at this point we just have to move on. We've beat that horse to death multiple times. Drivers, AJ Allmendinger was added. That's always nice. Cars and schemes, there were some things, some bugs and different issues fixed there. But now let's get down into the part that really matters to me, because I sort of separate the bug fixes and the patches into two categories moving forward. Number one, there's your standard fixes for the different bugs and issues that have crept up. These are things that are simply not working properly. Then there are AI things. And the AI issues are the ones that will keep me from playing and enjoying the game long term. In fact, they're why I stopped playing the game for a week or so here most recently. Until the AI behavior is at least decent, then I can't have fun with the game, regardless of any other issues that might be there. So that's sort of how I look at the patches moving forward. This particular patch, when I'm considering the beginning of the process, well, it really addressed several things that needed to be, including the yellow flag. So as we move down through this first section, rules, cautions, and yellow flags, this was a huge issue, something that we've seen here on the channel in our own gameplay. So first off, we start with the sensitivity of the yellow flags. Yes, sometimes you can have huge crashes and no cautions whatsoever. Other times, I've seen cautions and I'm not even sure why the caution was thrown. So hopefully this sensitivity issue has been addressed at least a little bit better. I'm certainly not expecting it to be perfect at this point, but hopefully it is a major step forward. Okay, and then we get improved player and AI formation on the rolling starts after the yellow flag. We have definitely seen this here on the channel in our gameplay, where you line up after a caution flag and then it becomes demolition derby as you take the green once again. Then we're going to move down a little bit further into fixed an issue that caused autopilot to retain control of the player car. That is definitely not something you want to see. I understand needing to have autopilot for certain sections. It's just the way the game is designed, but you certainly do not want the AI driving your car during the race or during important portions of the race. All right, now let's move on into the AI portion. And this is what I'm going to need to see great improvements to in the near future. So adjusted the AI to better handle large obstacles. I think by now we've all seen the videos and the footage of huge wrecks happening on the track and the AI simply piling in one after one until you have most the entire field as part of the wreck. So hopefully this has been addressed to a large degree. Again, I will continue to reiterate, I don't expect it to be perfect. I don't expect us to go to from where we were with this game and the complete train wreck that it is and has been to perfection overnight, but hopefully we're making great strides. Adjusted AI behavior after yellow flags, that sort of comes back to what we were talking about before, how they just sort of pile in demolition derby style after the yellow flags. Adjusted the AI behavior so they don't suddenly slow down at Charlotte when they're exiting the pits. And that's something I haven't seen personally because I haven't spent very much of any time at Charlotte. But yeah, I can see how that would be a huge issue. And then finally, this is something that I'm really happy to see. Fix an issue that would cause the AI to receive tire wear at an accelerated rate, which resulted in too frequent pit stops. This is something we've seen over and over in our gameplay here on the channel, where essentially the AI, if you're doing a 50 lap race where you've got plenty of fuel to make it the entire 50 laps, you as the player are going along just fine, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, all of the AI start pitting, and it appears as though this was the issue behind it since day one. So hopefully that has been addressed so that you can have a full fuel run against the AI and actually get to run a full fuel run without any issues on that front. Then we move down through a few other things, wear and damage, pit stops, again, which kind of goes back to what we were talking about here earlier, rules and cautions with the pit stops, the career mode, which really should be renamed championship mode because there's not a whole lot of career to it, but they do have a few adjustments there, which is always nice, and then some multiplayer enhancements as well. I haven't spent a lot of time in the multiplayer because, quite frankly, it was kind of a mess when I did get in there before, but we've got replays and some paint booth issues, as well as some basic bug fixes that have needed to be taken care of up until now. So we've got, again, going back to sort of my separation of how I look at these patches going forward, there are the bug fixes, things that are broken and need to be fixed in the game, and certainly several of these have been addressed with this patch, and hopefully more will be addressed going forward. But then the second part of it is the real playability, the fun of the game, and I think that's where these type issues are going to be very important going forward. How can we manage the AI behavior and make them to where we can actually race against them rather than simply trying to run for our lives and avoid them? So that's patch 1.2.5. I'll put a link to the NASCAR 21 website so you can take a look at the patch notes for yourself. That's going to do it for today. Thank you guys so much for joining me, and stick around for more NASCAR 21 Ignition.